likes it. Don't you, Brian? I reckon that pacemaker of yours must be jigging around like a puppet, and I'm pulling the strings. Now, who's top dog?
Don't, or you'll kill her!
Who's top dog, Bunny Brian?
You are! Will you let it go?
Members of the jury, have you reached a verdict?
We have. We find the defendant guilty as charged.
And is this the verdict of you all?
It is.
You have performed your duties in a true and proper fashion.
That's enough to get you out of here.
Annie Jane?
Oh, shame. Boy, you gave me a fright. What are you doing here?
Well, I didn't know whether you'd want me here or not. But you do, don't you?
Of course I do. But listen...
I can stay with you, can't I?
Now, Shane, wait a minute. You've got a home now. What about your new parents?
They're not my parents. They hate me.
Shane.
That's why I ran away. And I'm never going back there again. Never.
I think you'd better sit down, Bobby. I've got something to tell you and it may come as quite a shock. Now, I'm sure you've got nothing to worry about.
But what's happened?
Well, first of all, I got this report on you from Mr. MacDonald.
But Mrs. Reynolds,
it's nothing like that. In fact, he's delighted with the way you're settling in. Your willingness, your attitude, in fact, everything about your behaviour, he's very happy with.
Well, then why can't I go back?
Just a minute, Bobby. Excuse me. Yes? Oh, good. They're here. Well, would you send them straight through? They're on their way. No, that's all right. Thank you.
Reynolds, why can't I go back to work tomorrow?
Well, something's come up and it means you're going to have to attend a hearing in the morning.
What sort of hearing?
A special parole hearing.
Parole hearing?
Mr. Jenkins.
Come in.
Hello, Mrs. Reynolds.
Dan! Oh, Jesus, it's great. G'day, Edie.
Hello, dear. Surprised you, did we?
Oh, I reckon. Mrs. Reynolds, how come they're here?
Well, perhaps you'd better tell us, Dan.
I'd be delighted to. Well, you see, it's this way, Bobby. Edie and I have applied for you to be released to us on licence.
If you still want to, that is.
For want to? Oh, would I what? Oh, is this what the meeting's about tomorrow?
Yes, and if it's successful, you'll be able to live with Stan and Edie and continue your apprenticeship from outside.
Oh, you rotten buggers! Oh, jeez, now look what you made me do.
Nice?
Great. Don't get anything like that over there. Can I have some more?
Look, how about we talk about why you ran away first, Now, there must have been a reason.
Because I want to be with you.
Yes, I know, mate, but that's not possible. I'm going to have to take you back.
No, you can't. You wouldn't. Anyway, there'd be no point. They don't want me.
Now, what makes you say that?
It's true. They don't even like me. They just want someone to pick on all the time.
Oh, I find that a bit hard to believe, Shane.
I wouldn't lie to you, honest. They hate me.
All right. What makes you think they're picking on you?
Well, for instance, the other night I had to go to bed without any tea. Just because I had a little smudge on my homework. And I was starving too.
Right. What else?
Well, Mr. Taylor said if he caught me watching TV again in the mornings, he'd belt me.
Oh, come on, I find that a bit hard to believe.
It's true. He meant it. And that dumb kid Tracy, I hate her.
Why?
Because she's always doing rotten things so I get the blame. And she does it on purpose. You won't send me back, will you?
What say we have a bite to eat and then we can talk some more?
Good thinking, Auntie Jane.
It's not to scale, is it?
No, I thought I'd do that later.
Good. What about the ears, though? Where do you think they should go?
How about on the head?
Oh. Top of the class, too.
Look, why don't I go and get the original drawing? You think that might help?
Good idea. Yeah, it might give me a better idea where we're heading.
And we can throw the idea around a bit more, don't you?
Oh, Mrs. Barry, where's Bobby?
Well, she's still with Mrs. Reynolds.
Is she in trouble?
Can't help you. Sorry.
Look, where's Delaney?
I think he's still in the library, Mrs. Barry.
Right.
Hey, do you mind if I go to my side? I forgot something.
Sure, you can keep me coming to the gates.
How's your daughter getting on those
days? We've got half an hour. Let's go and collect.
What about Barry?
It's okay. They're splitting up the gates. Little birdie told me that Mitchell's in the pound.
Oh, yeah? Rack off.
Just wanted to stop you worrying.
Oh, cop that. What a wimp.
Why? Just because she did something nice?
No, because she's got no guts. Reminds me of someone else I know.
Who?
Me? Yeah. Suppose it's not your fault, but your whole family are a pack of wimps.
At least my mum wasn't a child basher.
You stupid bitch! You wouldn't understand cutthroat! I'm sick and tired of you and shut up! Don't you ever down my mother again, Warren! Okay, so she beat up on me a couple of times, but only because I deserved it.
Hey, settle down. Marlene didn't mean anything.
At least my mum made me tough enough to stand on my own 2 feet. But look at you, you fat slug.
Guess what, everyone? Where's Jude? I might be getting out, Rabbit.
That's
fantastic.
Great news, Bobby.
Great.
Congratulations.
Hasn't got any bloody ears. What do you want?
Not very friendly. Is she frank?
Reckon I should give her a bit of slap and tickle? Bring her around?
Not pretty enough. And besides, she's still missing her girlfriend, aren't you, Bride?
Get out.
Sure.
As soon as you cough up your protection money.
You've got to be kidding. You're not getting a cent from me.
Sorry. I'm a bit hard of hearing. Say it again.
I said you're wasting your breath.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. I don't think she likes me, Lou.
Yeah, we're going to have to teach you some manners, Brian.
Easier to pay up, love.
She's going to pay up anyway. We're going to have your buy up.
I mean,
you wouldn't want to be in debt to us, now would you?
She is.
Sorry, I really needed that.
Well, it's all over now. Wright got 8 years. That'll be the last you ever see of him.
Mm. Except when I wake up terrified from some nightmare.
Meg, it's all behind you. It's over.
Is it?
Of course it is. It'll need some adjustment, of course. You'll have to work at that. But I will be around.
Thanks. But I don't think they'll let you hold my hand on the operating table.
If you are so determined to make this a miserable night, I'll have to tell you some of my jokes. I'm the only one who ever laughs at them anyway. Look, have another drink, then you'll start feeling human.
Thanks, Chris.
Are you sure you're all right, Jude?
Yeah, I'm fine, love. I'm sorry I'm putting a damper on your party mood. I'm really glad for you, Bobby.
That's okay. At least I get away from creeps like him.
Yeah, yeah, rotten buggers. Right. Don't worry, Myra will be back soon. She'll take care of them.
Yeah, why can't Matt and Jeff help us out?
No.
Why do you have to ask anyone for help? Why can't you fight your own battles?
Because Myra is the top dog. Now, we don't do anything without her okaying
it. Yeah, that includes selling dope. Have a guess what they're doing right now.
I reckon you're just complaining because they're making a few bucks. That's just...